Hi, this is Russell Stannard from teachertrainingvideos.com. If you're using Gmail or in fact working with your Google Drive, you're going to find this video really useful. I'm going to show you some really quick techniques for deleting mass emails, including in the last example, I'm going to delete so many emails that I'm actually going to save myself something like 2 gigabytes or more, I think, of space. So if you've got problems because you've got loads of emails and you need to sort them out and you want to delete masses of emails in one go, I'm going to show you some of the best techniques you can use. Really hope you like the video. As always, if you do, please like it, please share it, and of course, please comment on it. Let's get going. Okay, so tip number one to really delete content very quickly. You've got three main folders where your basically all your emails will arrive, either in primary, in social, or in promotions, or of course, as you know, you've got a spam folder. Now, often in promotions, you get lots of things that you don't want to keep, and that often builds up. And obviously, the easiest way to do it is to click here, and that will select the first 50, and then you can delete them. Okay, so I can select these and then I can delete. However, that's a really inefficient way of working. Let me just do that a second time and show you a much quicker way. I'm going to select them all. And instead of just deleting 50, notice here it says select all 819 conversations. So if I now click on that button, it's now selected all of the emails in my promotions folder. And if I now click on delete, it's actually going to delete all 819 emails all in one go. And that's really going to clear up my inbox. Okay, and now you can see that my promotions tab is completely empty. There's just a couple of ads there at the top. Occasionally, you have to do that a couple of times actually. Occasionally, it doesn't quite clear out everything, and you find that at the end you do have to kind of just delete the odd few. But that is a really quick way of deleting your emails. So, my second tip is one that I use all the time, and I'm going to demonstrate this by clicking here on social. Now, I'm going to go to advanced search here. So I'm just going to click here on my search options and I'm going to specifically search for a particular email, and that is any email that's come from YouTube. Now the reason I'm doing that is because I already go onto my YouTube channel to reply to my comments. So actually the fact that it's also added onto my as an email to me, a warning to me every time a comment comes, is really not that useful. So I want to delete all of these. So what I've done there is I used the search button at the top, search specifically for YouTube, written exactly the way I can see that it's written here in the subject. And then what I can do now is again, select all. Again, the same thing's going to happen. Select all conversations that match that search. So not only the first 50, but again, I'm going to click here and then it's going to select all of them. And now again, I could click on delete and absolutely all of those emails will also be deleted. So this is now being really specific about the emails that you actually want to delete. And there they are. They've all gone. So the first thing we're going to do is click on the search button up here to do an advanced search. And we're going to come down to size greater than, and we're just going to write in a number. We'll choose 15 megabytes. Okay, and I'm going to click on search. And that's basically going to show me now all of the emails that I've received that have an attachment bigger than 15 megabytes. Now, obviously, if I delete all of these, I'm going to create myself loads of space. However, I might be a little bit worried about deleting all of them. Okay, remember, if we click on this button here, it's going to select only the first 50. But if we click also here, it's now going to select absolutely all of them. So this obviously will delete, and this will probably take a few minutes if you've got a lot of files to delete. So there's a nice little trick here I can do to perhaps stop myself deleting just all of them and maybe just keep the last ones that have been open, perhaps because I haven't read them yet or because I still think I might be working with them. So I can click here and choose older than a month, for example. Okay, now what that's going to do is ch slightly change the search. We now have 15 megabytes, but older than a month. And again, now I'm going to select them all. I'm going to again select all conversations that match this search. So this search is larger than 15 megabytes, but older than a month. And I'm going to click again, select all, and now I'm going to delete those. And that is going to save a huge amount of space. Now, in my case, this is a lot of files. And if I now click on the delete button, it is going to warn me that this is actually going to affect some of my emails because some of the emails where I've been having various conversations with people will now change because we're deleting the attachment. But I'm quite happy to do that. I click on OK and it's done it almost immediately and everything now has gone to trash. And there's one final thing we need to do. Now, interestingly enough, I've deleted a huge number of files there, but it's still telling me that I've got 11 gigabytes of space being used on my or in my total amount of free space on Google. And the reason for that is that all of those things I've just deleted are still sitting in my trash. So the final thing that I will need to do after deleting everything I want to delete is to come down and find my trash. Okay, and then obviously click on it and then empty that. And that is where we're going to really start to save some space. So we should see if we click on this and it's going to delete more than 353 conversations in total now. Click on those, we're going to begin to delete lots and lots of messages. And hopefully, this will begin to give me more space. Now I'll need to refresh my email to see what impact that's had. As a final tip, once you've cleaned out everything, make sure, and obviously deleted everything from the trash as well, make sure that you refresh. That will update. Google will update. And if we jump over, I think, to the promotions, we'll probably see, yes, what a massive difference that's made. We're now down from 11.5 gigabytes to 7.86 gigabytes of content. So basically, now I've got half of my Google Drive free. So we just literally deleted 4.5 gigabytes. That's 4,500 megabytes of data with literally one click of a button. Really hope that video was useful to you. Please come over to teachertrainingvideos.com. Lots of different technologies across the top here, including a whole section on different Google tools. But if you want to learn more about digital skills, the types of things that I've just showed you in the last video, then click here. There's a great selection of videos that will help you with different digital skills. If you want to follow my work, the best thing to do is to sign up to the newsletter. That way you get updated with all the blogs, the webinars, the online courses, and of course the new videos. You can also subscribe to my YouTube channel. Don't forget to click on the bell so that you get updated when new videos come out. And finally, if you do want to contact me about me doing some training with your organization, you can contact me from the website. And thank you very much. I hope that video is useful, and there are some more videos that you can click on now, some more videos to help you introduce technology into your teaching and learning and to develop your digital skills.